guys, it's Allie. I'm here with another yoga flow. This one's gonna be more balance oriented. So I love teaching balance. We wobble, we fall down, have a laugh at yourself, and just keep moving. That's what you do. You fall down, get right back up. I find when people do balance poses in yoga, they do two things. They tense up and they stop breathing, which is not what you wanna do in yoga. So, smile, lighten the body, and breathe through it. Everything else is good. If you're doing those two things, you're doing yoga. So we might need a yoga strap. If you don't have one, grab a belt, roll up a towel. They work just as well. And if you're not practicing on a carpet or you have tight knees, grab a pillow. We'll be on our knees for a little bit. It's just a little extra padding. We're actually gonna start standing today. I like centering standing sometimes. So one hand on the heart, one hand on the belly. Just get a strong foundation, find a spot where you're comfortable in, and close the eyes and just begin to bring it down. Find that breath. You'll feel your hand rise on the chest on the inhale, come back to you on the exhale. Just let it soothe you down, just like waves at the beach. Inhale. Exhale. Keep those eyes closed and let yourself go inward. Shut off the exterior voices, the exterior world. There's no news, there's no drama, there's just your breath and your body. Find some stillness and find your breath. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Few more breaths every time. Just let it sink you down and relax you. Let it be soothing and calming. Two more deep breaths. Let your eyes softly open and just notice where you're at with just a little breath work. Should be a little bit more rooted. Hands out to the side and just start by twisting. Let your arms be free, shake it out. Have some fun with this. We're gonna interlace the fingers, go through the back and squeeze through. We're rounding our back and bringing it back. Rounding it and bringing it back. Scapular retraction, bring it back. So keep doing that. And now we're gonna push out, up, and then side to side. Keeping that breath going. Push out, round, up, side to side. Bring down the arms, shake them out, let them loose. Anything that feels good for your body. Shake out the wrists. We're gonna come on down to the ground. And we're gonna start in hero pose. So this is where that pillow comes into place. This can be intense on your knees. If that doesn't feel good, just pat it there. But so sit back. We're only gonna be here for a moment. We're actually gonna lift up, keep straight from our shoulder to our knees, arms float out, and we're gonna take it back. This is gonna be intense on the tops of the thighs. Slowly bring it back, inhale it forward. Exhale it back, inhale it forward. And you can challenge yourself by going further and further back. It's really gonna instantly warm up the legs. Now we're gonna link the arms and the breath. So inhale back, exhale, round. Inhale, go back, exhale, round. Shake it out. From here, toes go under, hands go down, flip it over, down dog. And this is the first one, so I always like to pedal out my legs, shake my head. If stillness is your game, you do that. But find a down dog that works for you. And breathe. Baby steps to the hands with bent knees. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, slowly down. In. Inhale, slowly rise up. Hands come to chest, maybe eyes close, and you just take a breath here. Eyes gently open, inhale the arms up. Swan dive them down, bent knees, plant the hands, feet go back. You're in plank position. And then from here, shoot out to your down dog. It might feel a little wide, but this is actually proper positioning. So don't worry about the heels going down, stretch it out. We're gonna do a few planks to down dog. So down dog, exhale. Inhale to plank, hold. Send it back, bring it forward. If you'd like a little bit more, add an arm to ankle, plank position, arm to ankle. This is just warming everything up. Link your body and your breath. Deep inhale, deep exhale. We've got two more. Last one, hold the plank. And then from here, one more down dog, push through, baby step all the way up. Maybe this time knees aren't bent. You can get a little bit more stretch if that feels okay. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, exhale down. Inhale, slowly, slowly rise. Hands to the chest. Shake out those hands. And we're gonna hit the neck. I find people often forget to stretch the neck. So we're just doing half circles here. A lot of athletes are really great about warming up and stretching, foam rolling. Keep rocking, hold at the side, let the ear come to the shoulder. But they always forget the neck. Open up the throat, chin up. Chin to chest. And that's always where I hold tension, so I really like it. We're gonna take the chin over to one shoulder, look as far as you can, slight little push, you'll feel the stretch along the side of the neck. Exhale to center and just flip sides. Breathe through. Inhale up, exhale the hands in. Inhale, rise. We're gonna go into goddess squat or goblet squat, whichever you prefer. So wide stance, I like my toes pointing out, and think of the back of the knees pushing. People tend to cave in during squats. You actually want the opposite. Shoulders right over the waist, hands come to goalpost arms, and go as deep as you can. So deep, inhale up. Exhale, back to that wide squat. We're gonna do a few of these. Inhale, lift. Exhale, down. Really use that breath as you come down. This time we're gonna turn to a lunge and go down to one side. If hands don't touch, bring it up to the knee, whichever is more comfortable. Sometimes the lower back doesn't like this, so come on up. But hold here, and then we're gonna cartwheel the arms up, back to that squat, and then cartwheel to the other side. Each side might be different, whichever feels good, but just hold the stretch. Think about the hips sinking down, knees right over the ankle. Cartwheel up, goblet squat, down to that lunge, cartwheel to goblet squat, and then one more. This time we're gonna add in one more stretch. Goddess squat to lunge. We're gonna stay here. The back knee is gonna bend, toes go under, and the front leg is gonna straighten out. You're gonna feel a pretty intense stretch along the posterior chain. If that doesn't feel good, bend the knee. You can go as deep with this as you want. If you're training for your splits, this is a great stretch. Just sink into this. Breathe through. Come out of it. Go to that lunge. Knee lifts up. Cartwheel the hands. Goddess squat. Come on down the other side. Find that squat first. Knee bends, toe under. Sit back. Get that really sweet stretch along the hamstrings. Hold and breathe. My toes are pointed up. This time I'm going to come to my lunge and come in straight-legged for a forward fold. As deep as you want it. Hands can be up, hands can be down, whatever feels good. And two breaths here. We're going to come up halfway, plant one hand, the other hand rises too. Knees can be bent if this doesn't feel good. Other hand comes down, and we just switch, stretching out the back. We're going to bring in the feet, so we're in a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale down. Inhale, slowly rise, strong. Gather what you need. Come on up. Palms meet. Hands to heart center. Just take a moment here. Feel that warmth growing in the body. Just check in with the mind and the body. Take a few breaths. Nice. Eyes gently open. We're going to start our balance series with tree. This is the traditional yoga pose. There are a few options. So I like to find my foundation first. With any balance, build from the ground up. Find one spot to look at, and then don't take your eyes off of it. That's how you build balance, and it's always a tight core. Use your breath as a tool. So one foot comes up, it can be low. If you have no balance whatsoever, kickstand, so your toes will go up. Maybe they go to the calf. Don't put it on the knee, but maybe it goes up a little higher, or you can actually even cross. This can be intense on the knee. So whichever one feels good to you, find that pose. You might wobble, it's all good. Think ground up, build, grow your branches, hold, and breathe. This is the part where we stop breathing and concentrate. Just smile and keep going through it. You're wobbling, it's all good. Two more breaths here. Release everything. Inhale the arms up. Exhale down. Inhale up the arms. Exhale. Stay where you are. I'm going to turn. We're going to go to chair to slight back bend. So bend the knees. Come on into chair. Hands rise. Biceps over ears. If that's intense on the shoulders, go forward. Hips turn under. Hold that. Let the breath keep moving though. Deep inhale, deep exhale. And inhale up. My hands come to my lower back, elbows trying to go together. Little baby back bend, very gentle. Drop the hands, inhale to chair, hold. Exhale, rise up, hands to the back. Little baby back bend. One more, inhale to chair. Exhale to baby back bend. I'm slightly pushing my hips forward, very gently opening it up. You'll actually feel it in the shoulders too. So build on the other side, find that base, feet wherever feels good, just not on the knee. Imagine you're between two panes of glass. The knee tends to travel forward. It's gonna be out. It should be in line with the hips. Hands out to branches. Maybe it's to the chest, whatever feels best and you feel like you can hold. Take a few deep breaths. Smile and breathe. One more. Release everything. Inhale up. Exhale. We're going to dive all the way down. Plant the hands. Feet go back. Plank position, hold here, exhale to down dog. Pedal it out, move through. Feet are gonna gently walk up to hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, slow rise. Bring it on up. Enjoy that stretch at the top. Take it down. All right, now we're gonna get a little fancy with balance. So find that spot that feels good. I like finding the four corners of my feet. I go side to side and then I plant. We're gonna start on the right side. Right leg comes up at a 90 degree angle. Toes are straight, yoga feet. Hold and breathe. I like my hands here. They can be anywhere that feels good. Find that spot. On the inhale, travel the knee and it's gonna go out to the side. Breathe through and then drift forward and back. That's it. Smile and breathe. Other side, 90 degrees, hold the body, but let the breath keep moving. Travel out to the side, opening up that hip. Try not to shift the balanced leg. Inhale back, release. Shake it out. Now we're gonna do some balancing figure four. So back to that right leg, 90 degrees. This time it crosses. My ankle is going above my knee and I'm sitting down, if I can, there we go, into a figure four. You're gonna feel a big, deep hip opening. That's where you're supposed to be. You can interlace the fingers, bring them up overhead if that feels good. Inhale, lift, gather, exhale. Few breaths here. Inhale, arms go up. Exhale down. Two more. Last one, make it good. Gather, release. Other side, leg goes up, you know what's coming. Cross it over, sit back, wah, maybe interlace, maybe go up, maybe wobble, anything you want. Sink into those hips though, keep that posture in line. Inhale out, take it back. All right, you guys are experts now, so we're going all in. We're gonna start with that right leg, 90 degrees. We're gonna take this, send it to warrior three. Hold, you're trying to make a T with your body. So my wrists and my foot are moving away from each other as my base leg is solid. Breathe through. And then in one motion, I come back to that raised knee. Yeah, there you go. All right, let's switch sides. I'm changing for camera angles. You can stay right where you are. Other side, inhale up. Find that balance first, then send it out. Warrior three. Your foot is gonna wanna turn out. Keep those hips centered to the floor. Hold and breathe. One movement. Inhale back up. Let it down. Beautiful, guys. So back to those chairs. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Breathe, exhale, arms come around on the back. Open up that throat. Inhale up, bring it down. All right, this is where that yoga strap comes into place. If you need it, if you don't worry about it. So we're gonna stand that 90 degrees. If you don't need this strap, two fingers wrap around the toe. If you do need this strap, just wrap it around. It's basically how tight your hamstring is. So we're going for a straight leg. That might not work for you, just bent. So find that balance. Inhale, exhale, straight leg. Find that one spot. Other hand goes up and around. If you want a challenge, like this isn't challenging enough, look behind you. One more breath, release. If you want a really big challenge, try doing it with your eyes closed. I'm not gonna do that. So, with or without a yoga strap, other side, 90 degrees, same side hand, ooh, I'm wobbling. I'm gonna breathe and smile. Fingers wrap around the foot. My leg is straight. I hold solid base leg. Maybe I stay here.
Maybe you add the arm, come around, look back, come back down, knee bent, bring it down. Wrap the arms. You should be working, but have fun with it. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Two more. Inhale, gather. Exhale, let go. This time we're gonna take a pause. So inhale, palms come together. Come on down to the chest. Close the eyes. Just check in with how you feel. We go inward. We let go of exterior stuff. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. All right, now we're gonna go back to that bounce. So leg comes up this time, goes back. We're gonna keep it at an angle and do some, I don't know the official names. I call them booty pops. So that's what we're gonna go with. Pop it out while you balance. Two, three, one motion. Come on back. Let it go. Swing out the arms. Take a breath. Other side. All right, so knee comes up, find that spot, slowly get to that space, and then heel goes to the sky. Booty pops. Two more. Come up one motion. Come on down. Last set of chairs. Chair hold. Come on back. Baby back bend. Maybe you go a little deeper since we're warm. Inhale to chair. Exhale to back bend. Last one. Breathe through. Now the last balance pose is the easiest, but probably the most important. It's the only Sanskrit word I'll ever use. It's called Tadasana because it's got Tada in it. And I just think that's cool. But it's mountain pose. You find your base, and this is about strength. So build from the ground up. Let that energy flow through your legs. Come on up, roll the shoulders down and back. Hands shoot out, palms spin forward. I like taking my pinkies and rotating them so much so I feel it in my triceps and I open my chest, close my eyes, and just breathe. Move those shoulders away from the ears and just gather. Feel that strength running through your body. Just let your mind find that clarity it craves with a little work and a little breath. Feel the strength of mountain pose. Deep inhale, pause. Deep exhale. Take a few more breaths. Just enjoy this moment for yourself. You're doing something for your body and for your mind. One more deep breath. Let it go. I think we'll end on that because that's just one of my favorites. So, couple breaths. Inhale up. Exhale down. Two more. Nice and slow. Gather. Release. Last one. Biggest. Exhale. We're going to come back to that hand over heart, hand over belly, a standing shavasana, or lay down, whatever speaks to you, whatever's right for you. But wherever you are, close those eyes. Try to connect to your heartbeat, that hand over your chest. And then see if it slows down for you. Connect with your own heart. Inhale. Me.
Maybe you've been carrying something with you, and now it's time to let it go. Drop whatever no longer serves you. Inhale what you need. Exhale what you don't. Breathe in. Breathe out. Let those waves wash over you. Release any tension. Just let it all go. Sink down into the earth. I hope this class brought you whatever you needed. Namaste.